Tell you the truth today. If, after what I'm saying today, if you don't want to give me money, you can keep it. Because when we get to the presence of God, I have said my own. If you don't do it, God, you will account for it before God. Well, God will crown me and God will do otherwise. The book of Proverbs says that the wise woman would build a house. That's why she shut your mouth. Whatever happened in your family, hide it. Whatever is happening between you and your husband, hide it yourself. When you allow outsiders to interfere, the family might not stand anymore. The bad prophecy, the wrong prophecy that the family, the man of God or the prophet is telling some family has scattered some family. If you go to those men of God, those men of God will say, your husband is a fighter, he's an angry man. That's what they will tell you. He's an angry man, he's a fighter. That's what they will tell you. My husband sleeps a lot. What I'm trying to say is that whatever you tell that man of God, he will be telling that, he will be tailoring that prophecy in that direction. That's what he's trying to say. So most of us women, we curse it. You now turn yourself to bank ATM to this man of God. The Bible says in that same part, he said, be careful of the fake prophet. The Bible says, by their fruit, you shall know them. Look at me. Brethren, especially women. If you, look at me, if you go and meet a man of God, if you meet a man of God, he will pray for you. I'm expecting something from you. That vision is not from God. It's because of that money. That vision is not from God. If a man of God is calling you, he knows you want to give him money. Such a man of God is not a man of God. That man of God is close to you because what he wants to get from you. Say hallelujah. Thank you.